will be showing the functional examination. How to do the functional examination for a case. First and foremost is how the patient should be seated is important. So when we should make sure that the head is in undressed position and the patient should stay straight. Patient should stay undressed position. Mundanvari, we should see patient should stay straight. So we have to get first mandible into rest position. We should get the mandible to rest position. So we can tell some work for patient to get it to physiological rest position. Yam ada yam madam yam 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 om 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 om. We should stand in front of the patient and you have to check for the path of closure in the functional examination. How do we do it? So first the patient in the patient head is undressed position, sitting state, mandible receptor position. From physiological rest position to occlusion. Catching it on a catch? Yes. Well, from physiological rest to rest position, when the patient bites, it will be from first the patient will get into initial contact, then final occlusion position. So, if the patient bites, touching. So you can observe the path of closure, how the mandible works. Whether they bite in the straight position or they will get forward path of closure or backward path of closure. The closure from rest position to occlusion, final occlusion, if it is straight, that is straight path of closure. If the mandible is straight, if it's straight forward, it is forward path of closure, which is usually seen in class 3 malocclusion. If the path of closure is backwards, that is the path of closure is backward, which is usually seen in class 2 division 2 malocclusion. So this is how we see the functional examination path of closure.